Hello teachers, I'm Prachi Pasalkar. I'm Senior Teaching Associate at ISA Pune and today I'm here to discuss a lesson plan made by Mrs. Yogini Mahadalkar from Nyan Prabodhini Prashala Pune. She has made this in collaboration with Science Activity Center, ISA Pune. She has also tried this lesson plan with her students and have shared her experiences with us. So welcome to this physics video lesson plan on a very interesting topic of magnetic effects of electric current. Students learn this topic in their 8th and 10th class. We have tried to make this lesson interactive and activity based. So let's begin with our first activity. For this activity, we will need ball bearings in a bowl, coins, few neodymium magnets. Count how many coins can stick to the magnet when arranged one after the other. Also, stick one coin to the magnet, dip it in the bowl of ball bearings and count the number of ball bearings that stick to the coin. Repeat this with more coins. While doing this activity, you can ask students to predict how many ball bearings stick to the coin at each step. This is a very nice and introductory activity to hook students' attention to this topic. After this activity, you can ask a question to the students that can we make a magnet? If yes, then how? And have a discussion on this question. This question leads us very nicely to our next activity. For this activity, we will need a PVC pipe, a piece of card sheet with holes on it as shown here, a compass, a cell of 1.5 volt, a bare copper wire. Let's make a solenoid using the PVC pipe. Now, wound the bare copper wire on the pipe passing through these holes. Place a magnetic compass inside the solenoid such that the magnetic needle is parallel to the vertical axis. Now, connect the circuit and observe the deflection of the compass needle. After this activity, you can ask students that have we used a magnet here? You can also ask that can we change the direction of deflection of the needle here? You can explain what is right hand thumb rule, which states that if I imagine to hold a current carrying conductor in my right hand, then the stretched thumb denotes the direction of the current and the curled fingers denote the direction of the magnetic field. So in this activity, you can ask students to identify the direction of the current and the magnetic field. It is difficult for students to visualize how magnetic field is generated in the conductor. Since they see it happening here, in this activity, they will not forget this concept soon. So let's see one more interesting activity on this concept to make a galvanometer. To make a galvanometer, we will need a compass, a battery, insulated copper wire and a cutter. Wrap the wire tightly around the compass such that it is aligned with the needle of the compass. So we will be able to see the needle's deflection clearly. Leave about 10 cm of wire at each end and remove its insulation. Let's connect it to the circuit. Wow, we can see the needle deflecting. While doing this activity, you can ask that why is the needle showing deflection? If we change the polarity of the battery, can we change the direction of deflection of the magnet? You can also ask one more question. That if you increase the windings of copper wire on the compass, what will happen? Students will really enjoy this activity and understand the magnetic effects of electric current. We have one more very interesting activity related to this topic. Let's see that. For this activity, we will need a razor blade, a string is attached to it, a 1.5 volt battery, a copper coil, and a cardboard base. Suspend the blade in the middle of the coil such that the blade is aligned to the coil as you see here. Mount the coil in the slit of the cardboard and connect the circuit. The blade starts rotating and aligns itself at 90 degrees with the coil. the magnetic field is produced by the current flowing through the coil. It is advised to do this activity along with the students under your supervision. You can ask the questions like, why is the blade deflecting? On what parameters does the deflection of blade depend on? If you replace the blade by some other material, what will happen? Will it still deflect? So you can ask this question and have a nice discussion on this. So let us start with one more very interesting activity on this topic to make an electromagnet. For this activity, you will need a big iron needle or a nail, insulated copper wire, 1.5 volt battery, paper clips. Take a needle and 20 gauge copper wire and wound the wire around the needle as you see here. Keep two ends of the copper wire free for connections. Check the magnetic properties by going near to the paper clips. Connect the two ends of the copper wire to the battery and bring the needle close to the paper clips. The needle becomes an electromagnet and can attract the paper clips over here. After this activity, you can ask the following questions to the students. What is the similarity between this activity and the solenoid activity? Why does the needle get magnetized? Why does the paper clips get attracted towards the needle? You can also ask to identify the directions of magnetic field and current in this activity. This is an interesting activity where students make an electromagnet and experience the joy of this interesting concept. To sum up this session, you can ask some more interesting questions to the students and have a discussion later. You can ask that how electricity and magnetism are related. What is the effect of current passing through the coil? Can you state some real life examples of this concept? We have used simple collection of materials which are cost effective and can be reused. The biggest advantage of these activities is it makes the lesson more lively. Instead of dumping laws, definitions, equations, and diagrams on students, teaching using hands-on activities will help them to understand and retain the concepts better. Hope this will help you to make your teaching interesting. There are more interesting activities related to this topic. The detailed lesson plan is given in the description box below. Thanks for watching.